Hi, this is Dr. Sandeep Rai Sarkar, assistant professor from Holy Cross College, Agartala. In my today's class, I am going to discuss about mutations. So, welcome you all today in my class. And today's topic of discussion is the mutations. So, first of all, what is the definition of mutation? So, by definition, any sudden change or the permanent alteration in the base sequence of DNA. That means it is related to the change in the DNA sequence. So, how can we define any sudden change or a permanent alteration? What type of alteration? Either it may be addition or it may be deletion or it may be some other type of changes. That phenomenon is known as mutation. Now, mutation may involve a chemical change in only a single nucleotide of the DNA sequence. If that involved, generally it is, most cases it is involved in a chemical change related to a single nucleotide of the DNA sequence. And that type of mutation is known as point mutation. Since it is occurring in a point in a single base, what are the different bases of DNA? They are having purines and the pyrimidines. Purines may be adenine and guanine, and pyrimidines are thymine and cytosine. Another one is there, which is uracil, which is useful for the RNAs. So these are the bases. So any change in a single base sequence is the point mutation. So there are two types of point mutation. One is the base pair substitution. Since we know the DNA is having two strands, two pairing strands, so it's related that it is a base pair substitution, not a single base, a pair of base changes. Second one is the frame shift mutation. What is the frame? This frame is actually means the reading frame. Since we know that in case of translation, three bases forming a codon, that means a codon is consisting of three bases, and these three bases forming a frame, and from each of these codon, which codes during the translation, which codes one amino acid. So that is the frame, three bases, each codon is forming a detail. First one is the these are the bases for the DNAs, and how the bases will bonded with each other. Adenine, with using two hydrogen bonds, it can bond with the thymine. That is the normal one. Adenine can bond with thymine using two hydrogen bonds, and the guanine can bond forming a bond with the cytosine using the three hydrogen bonds. So A will bond with the T by double bond, and G will form bonding with the cytosine using triple bond. That is the normal one. Not the mutated one, that is the normal one. Now, during the mutation, this bond formation, these bases, their side chains, or their double bonds, or their amino group, imino group, hydroxyl group, this will change during the mutation. Okay. So, first thing, the base pair substitution. What is the base pair substitution? This is a type of mutation when a nucleotide of a triplet is replaced by another nucleotide. A nucleotide of a triplet is replaced by another nucleotide. What is triplet? Triplet actually the three bases which are forming one codon. That is the triplet. From a triplet, one nucleotide may be replaced. The replace, it may be deleted, one base, one nucleotide, or one nucleotide may be added. So that is the type of base pair substitution when a nucleotide is replaced by another nucleotide. This is the most common type of mutation. Which one? The base pair substitution. Now this is having two forms. What are the two forms? One form is transition, another form is transversion. So, since we know that there are two types of nitrogenous bases, what is the composition of a DNA? It is having the phosphate group, it is having the ribose sugar, deoxyribose sugar in case of DNA, and the nitrogenous bases. So two types of nitrogenous bases are there, purines and the pyrimidines. The purines are adenine and guanine, and the pyrimidine are others, that is thiamine and the cytosine. Uracil may be there in possible in case of RNAs. So now in the transition form of base pair substitution, if a purine is replaced by another purine, in case of transition type of base pair substitution, when a purine is replaced by another purine, or when a pyrimidine is replaced by another pyrimidine, no interchange is possible, no interchange is allowed. Pyrimidine can be replaced by only pyrimidine, purine can be replaced by only purine. This type of base pair substitution is known as transition. Another type is transversion, where there is interchange is allowed. That is, when a purine is interchanged or replaced by a pyrimidine, or a pyrimidine is replaced by a purine. That is the transversion. So transition, when there is no interchange, only purine is replacing purine, pyrimidine is pyrimidine. But in case of transversion, purine can be replaced by pyrimidine, or the vice versa. Now look at the picture. Some cross separate structure are given in between. So what is the transition? The blue markings, the blue arrows are transition, where a pyrimidine, that is adenine and guanine, both are pyrimidine. So A can be replaced by G, or G can be replaced by A. Cytosine and thiamine, these are pyrimidines. So C can be replaced by T, or T can be replaced by C. That means, just look at the blue colored line. If purine is replaced by purine, or if pyrimidine is replaced by pyrimidine, that is transition type of base pair substitution. What are the transversion? Look at the red color arrows. In case of transversion, the interchange is going on. What is the interchange? Purine is changed by, replaced by a pyrimidine, or a pyrimidine is replaced by purine. That is, A can be replaced by C, C can be replaced by G, can be T. That interchange is known as the transversion type of base pair substitution. Second type, that is the frame shift mutation. What is frame shift mutation? Since we know that I just told that during the translation process, number of frames are there. See, look at, these are the frames. So three bases are forming a codon. Say for example, if you look at the number A, first example at the top one, top left corner, G, C, C, A, T, T. Actually, these three bases are forming one codon. And during the process of translation, each codon is having a specific tRNA, and that tRNA will bring a particular type of amino acid for the translation process. So each codon is coding a specific type of amino acid. So that means three bases forming a codon. So that is the frame. So frame shift mutation is a type of mutation, is a type of point mutation, in which there is addition or maybe deletion of one or a few nucleotide is possible. What was the base pair substitution? There is mutation in only one base. But in this case, there may be change in only one or more than one nucleotide. That is the difference. So in case of frame shift mutation, there is change. That change may be either addition or maybe deletion in not only one, more than one nucleotide. Because of that change, the frame will be shifted. Now, this frame shift mutation results in a new sequence of codons which may code for a different amino acid. That I'll show you in next figure how it will changes. So the frame shift mutation may be deletion, that means removal, or insertion, that is addition of one or more than one, two or three bases may be there. What is the example? Now look at the first example. Can you find the third codon, that is TAT, Just look at there. The T is red mark. This one. The T is red mark. So this T is deleted. What is the codon in next one? The codon was GCC 141, 142, 143, 144. What is there in 143? TAT. Now this T is deleted. So now it will be TAG. That is the first base from the 144 number codon. Since the last codon, since the last base of 143 number is deleted, now the last base of 143 number will be the first base of 144 number of codon. So that's how the frame changes, the frame shifted. That is actually the frame shift mutation. So what is the result in this case? In this case, it is a nonsense mutation because the TAT or the TAG both are denoting a same amino acid. That is, the sense is changed. I mean, sense is not changed, remains same. That's why it is nonsense mutation. Or if you go to the example of B, the look at the 37th codon, ATA. So ATA, where the G is inserted in case of A. In the second, I am talking about the B example, example B, capital B. 37th codon is ATA, where one G is inserted in case of A. So the codon was actually ATA. Now because of G is inserted, the codon is GTA. So now the 37th codon is GTA and the 38th codon is having another one because of replacement of G. So that is the change. Or if you look at the deletion, example number D, where four bases are deleted from 170 and 171 codon. Four bases are deleted. So that is the frame shift mutation. We have another example. That is the example. Look at the wild type codon. AUG codes methionine, AAG codes lysine, UUU codes phenylalanine, GGU codes glycine. Now at the third codon, that is UUU, which codes for phenylalanine, one deletion occurs. What is the deletion? UUU, the last U is deleted. Actually, UUU is coding the phenylalanine. Because of the deletion of last U, now the frame is UUG. And this UUG is now coding the leucine. So that is the change in the codon, which UUU, which is actually coding the phenylalanine. Because of the deletion of one U, now the frame is now UUG and it is now coding the leucine. So the amino acid code changes. Third one, the last one, bottom one, the first base AUG, which is coding methionine, the second base, which is AAG, coding the lysine. Now because of addition of one U at the second codon, in place of AAG, which is coding lysine, the new codon is now UAA, which is not coding any amino acid, rather it is a stop codon. So the AAG, which is coding the lysine, now this is coding UAA, which is a stop codon. That's how, because of change in one base, either addition or deletion or more than one base, the total amino acid coding is changed. The amino acid which is formed during the translation is changed. That is the frames. Okay, so next type we have, that is spontaneous mutations. So two types are there actually. One is the spontaneous mutation, another one is the induced mutation. So what is the induced type? The induced type, when there are some inducers, some factors, external one, which induces, which forces the mutation to occur. This type is the spontaneous one, when there is no forces, no factor which is causing this mutation, but this occurs due to spontaneous phenomenon. This is also known as the tautomerization. Actually the molecules, the bases, nitrogenous bases, has an ability to exist in more than one chemical form. What are the nitrogenous bases? The purines and the pyrimidines, adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine or uracil. These bases, they have an ability to exist in more than one chemical form. That ability, that property is known as the tautomerism. And property of being in the to change their form, the shift their form, is the tautomeric shift. What is that? The hydrogen atoms which are present in the nitrogenous bases, these hydrogen atoms can move from one position to the another position in a purine or a pyrimidine basis, from a amino group to a ring nitrogen. This property is the tautomeric shift. I repeat, the hydrogen atoms which are present in the nitrogenous bases, these hydrogen atoms can move from one position to the another position, either in a pyrimidine or a purine, from an amino group to a ring nitrogen. This shifting, this changes, this property is the tautomeric shift, and the ability of the molecule to exist in more than one form is known as the tautomeric form, tautomerism. Now, what is the tautomerism? Let me explain with some more thing. The adenine and the cytosine remain in more stable amino form, and the guanine and the thiamine remain in more stable keto form. In the stable form, in the normal structure, in the normal DNA, when there is no mutation occurring, the adenine and the cytosine remain in amino form, NH2 form, which is more stable, and the guanine and the thiamine remain in the keto form, double bond CO form, which is the more stable. But because they are having this tautomerism property, because of the tautomeric shift, the adenine and the cytosine, they can change from its more stable amino form to the imino form, single bond NH, imino form, which is the less stable. As well as, due to the same tautomeric shift, the guanine and the thiamine, which are generally exist in the more stable keto form, but because of this tautomeric shift, guanine and the thiamine, they can change tautomeric shift and they can undergo to a enol form, single bond OH, enol form, which is less stable. And because of this changes in its stable to non-stable form, this causes in the mismatch base pairing. This tautomeric shift results in the mismatch base pairing. Now, these are the common forms. The left hand side, we are having the common forms, thiamine, guanine, cytosine and the adenine. Look at the red arrows, small red arrows are given there. These red arrows actually signifies how the hydrogen will shift it from one to the another position. So, the left hand side, we are having all the common forms, the stable forms, and in the right hand side, these are the rare forms, which are the unstable form, and they are rare. Look at the in the rare form, the right hand side, because of the, in case of, since we let us consider the example to the first one, that is the thiamine, because of change the hydrogen position to the another one, the thiamine will now shift from its keto form to the less stable form, OH form. That is the rare form. So all are having this same thing. All are having the same thing. The adenine, cytosine, guanine and thiamine, generally, commonly, they are present in their stable form, but because since they are having the tautomeric property, tautomerism, tautomeric shift, they can change into its less stable form, which is the rare. It is rare, it is less stable, that's okay. But because of this property, there is mismatch base pairing. How the mismatch base pairing occurs? We should know, we should remind that this is the common base pairing, where the one adenine can base pair with the thiamine and the guanine will base pair with the cytosine. I repeat, the adenine will base pair with the thiamine with double bond, and the guanine will base pair with the cytosine using the triple bonds.
That is the common base pairing arrangement. But because of the tautomeric shift, there is some unusual mismatch base pairing. Just remember A with T double bond, G with C triple bond. Now look at the change. This is the rare base pairing arrangement where A can bond with the C with double hydrogen bonds and G can base pair with T with triple bond. Because the bonding is possible in this case because of shifting of the hydrogen to its which make its rare form because of the tautomeric property of these bases. So A can bond with adenine can bond with cytosine, guanine can bond with the rare form of thiamine, which is not possible in the common form or the normal form. It is possible in the rare form because of the tautomeric shift of all these bases. This causes the mismatch base pairing, and this figure shows the rare mismatch base pairing arrangement possible only because of the tautomeric property of the nitrogenous bases. Next one, that is the induced mutation. Previous one was the spontaneous mutation where tautomeric shift, tautomerism is possible because of the spontaneous property of the bases. Now we are going to discuss induced mutation when there is some inducer, some factor, some forces are active. So induced mutation is the mutation which occurs as a result of various agents, various factors which increases the frequency of mutation. And these agents are generally called mutagens, and these mutagens causes AT to GC transition and the GC to AT transition or the mutation. This is the type of induced mutation. Let me explain in detail. So there are a number of mutagens are acting. One mutagen is the base analog. What are the base analog? The base analogs are 5-bromouracil. This is the base analog 5-bromouracil. Another one is the 2-aminopurine. Look at the left hand side, the 5-bromouracil, and then look at the right hand side, the 5-bromouracil is actually the base analog or the substitute for the thiamine, since it is having the almost same structure except the BR group. Okay, so that is the difference between the base analog and the normal base. So base analog 5-bromouracil is the substitute for thiamine. Another base analog 2-aminopurine, which is the substitute for the adenine. So two base analog 5-bromouracil, 2-aminopurine, substitute for thiamine and the adenine respectively. Now what is the result? See, the adenine, which is commonly base pair with the thiamine, or the guanine, which is commonly base pair with the cytosine. Now because of the 5-bromouracil, the adenine can base pair with the 5-bromouracil and the guanine can base pair with the 5-bromouracil. So 5-bromouracil, 5-BRU, which is a base analog and which is substitute for the thiamine, because of presence of this 5-bromouracil, now adenine can base pair as well as the guanine can also base pair with the 5-bromouracil, and adenine can base pair with the keto form of 5-bromouracil, guanine can base pair with the enol form of 5-bromouracil, since 5-bromouracil can exist in both the keto and the enol form. So this is the mismatch base pairing which results because of presence of this base analog like 5-bromouracil. We have another base analog which is 2-aminopurine. This is the 2-aminopurine. Look at the structure, 2-aminopurine, which is colored in quite orange color. That is 2-aminopurine, which is having an amino group, NH2 group, at the second carbon position. Look at the, let's try to find out. At the second carbon position, it is having an NH2 group. That's why it is named as 2-aminopurine. Now this 2-aminopurine, which is a base analog, and this 2-aminopurine is a base analog for adenine. Now this 2-aminopurine can bond, mismatch bond with the thiamine as well as These two aminopurine can also form a bond, a single bond with the cytosine. Now these two aminopurine base analog can bond with the thymine as well as the cytosine. That is the mispair which is going on because of presence of this base analogs. Next, some other agents are there, some other inducing agents are there. The second type of inducing agent is nitrous acid, HNO2, nitrous acid. This nitrous acid is also acting as a inducing agent or inducer or a mutagen. Nitrous acid or HNO2 reacts with the bases containing the amino group. Who are the bases containing amino group? Adenine or the guanine. And this converts the amino group into the keto group, which changes the hydrogen bonding potential of the bases by oxidative deamination. What is going on? I repeat, the mutagenic agent, that is the inducing agent, the mutagen, nitrous acid, that is HNO2, this HNO2 reacts with the nitrogenous bases having the amino group. Who are the nitrogenous bases? A and G. And thereby it converts the amino group into the keto group, changes its hydrogen bonding potential by oxidative deamination. The figure is showing the cytosine because of the HNO2 nitrous acid. Now the uracil can be bonded with the adenine and the cytosine can be bonded with the hypoxanthine. Now what are the oxidative deamination, how it converts? Adenine to the hypoxanthine is converted because of oxidative deamination. Adenine can be converted into hypoxanthine, which base pairs with the cytosine. Normally this hypoxanthine will not base pair. Because of the oxidative deamination, adenine can be converted into hypoxanthine, and this hypoxanthine now base pairs with the cytosine rather than the thiamine. Normally the adenine can be bond with the thiamine, but because of the oxidative deamination by the nitrous acid, which is a mutagen, this adenine is now changes into hypoxanthine. Now hypoxanthine can base pair with the cytosine. Just think about the condition. Normally A can be bond with the T, but because of this presence of nitrous oxide, which changes its oxidative deamination, and the A is now is heavy changes into the hypoxanthine. Now A is bonded with the cytosine, not with the T. That is the thing. Now cytosine can be changed into uracil by oxidative deamination. This normally the cytosine can base pair with the G, but because of change of the cytosine, oxidative deamination, it changes into uracil. Now uracil base pairs with the adenine. That causes GC to AT transition. Guanine, what is the effect on guanine? Nitrous oxide causes the oxidative deamination upon guanine, and now guanine will change into the xanthine. So normally guanine can bond with the cytosine, but because of oxidation, now guanine is changed into xanthine, which is now base pair with the cytosine. So these are some of the actions, mechanisms of the mutagen. What is the mutagen? That is the nitrous oxide, which causes the induced mutations. So another one, the last one we have, I think it is the last one, that is the acridine dyes. Acridine dyes is the another most important mutagenic agent or inducing agent which induces the mutation. How acridine dye works? Just look at the bottom figure. The red thing, something is red which is intercalated in between the nitrogenous bases, in between the DNA bases. The acridine dyes, which the red one, which are intercalated, inserted in between the bases in a DNA strand. So two of the acridine dyes are there. One is the proflavin, another one is the acridine orange. So acridine dyes such as the proflavin or the acridine orange, they are very powerful mutagens that induces the frame shift mutation. So because of this acridine orange and the proflavin, because of their structure, they are considered similar to some bases, and when they are inserted, the reading frame considers them as a basis, and that causes the change in the that frame. So insertion of the actinidin dyes changes, actually causes the frame shift mutation, but this is a induced type of mutation which is induced by some mutagenic agents. In this case, actinidin dyes, we are having two examples. One is the actinidin orange, another one is the proflavin. Okay, so that's all from my side for today's class. If you have any kind of question, please ask, please text me or reply in the comment section. I will definitely answer. Hope this will clear about the topics. Okay, goodbye for today. Keep well, keep healthy, be safe. Goodbye.